Breadboards are often used as the foundation of a circuit, even though they don't have an influence over how the circuit behaves. In fact, that's exactly the point. A breadboard is meant to allow you to quickly and easily connect components together without having to use solder or alligator clips. You just plug components and wires into the breadboard and they're connected. Understanding the pattern of connections inside a breadboard is what this video is about. And now let's take a closer look. When you move your mouse over a hole in the breadboard, that hole will highlight, and so will other nearby holes that are electrically connected to it. What this means is if you put a wire into a hole, anything plugged into the nearby holes that also turn green will be electrically connected to that wire and whatever else you connect to the other end of it. Let's now use the breadboard to connect a light bulb and a battery. In this example, the battery doesn't need wires going directly to the light bulb because the breadboard itself creates the connections. If I want to move the light bulb to a different location in the breadboard, I'll need to use two wires to connect the light bulb's new columns to the columns the battery is already connected into. Did you know that 123D Circuits has several different size breadboards to choose from? Let's continue with a few example circuits. Here we have two circuits. On the right is a 9-volt battery connected in series with four light bulbs, and on the left is a 9-volt battery connected in series with four light bulbs. These are the same circuit, except one uses a breadboard. Let's press start simulation. The current flows from the positive terminal of the battery through the light bulbs that are connected by wires back to the negative terminal of the battery. On the left, current flows out of the battery, goes into the positive rail of the breadboard, goes up through a wire, goes back into the breadboard, and you can see these green highlights, and it goes into the light bulb, back out into the breadboard, through a wire, back and out, through a wire, back into the breadboard, into the light bulb, back into the breadboard, through a wire, back into the breadboard, through the light bulb, back into the breadboard, through the wire, into the negative rail of the breadboard, and back into the battery. We encourage you to try this for yourself. Open the circuit and move your mouse around and watch the highlights on the breadboard. Let's move to the next example. In this example, the 9-volt battery is connected to four light bulbs in parallel, and on the left, the 9-volt battery is connected to a breadboard, which is connected to four light bulbs in parallel. These circuits are identical, except that one uses a breadboard. Now you may notice that there are coordinates on the breadboard. This makes it really easy to explain to someone or to write out a diagram saying exactly where you want something to be connected. So here we see this wire plugs into column 11, row E. And then the wire jumps over this gap and finishes in column 11, row H. And you'll notice that A, B, C, D, and E are all connected in each column. And F, G, H, I, J are all connected in each column. But A, B, C, D, and E and F, G, H, I, J are never connected to each other. There's always a gap down the middle of a breadboard. To see more breadboard examples, continue watching part 2.